The news now, and we know the Parsi community across India struggling because of dwindling numbers. So how are they coping? Sonal Mehrotra finds out.
At 91, she's the oldest member of the Delhi Parsi Anjuman. Mrs. Idalji normally stays at home but has chosen to venture out to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Delhi's only Parsi temple. For a community that's dwindling, the significance of the occasion wasn't lost on its members.
I have about 500 permanent Parsis and say another 500 floating, and that's why it's essential that we get together at least once a year.
The Parsis have been in Delhi for over 140 years, much before the British came and made Delhi the capital, as they call it, the Darbar city. And we have graves here which are over 136 years old.
Special havans for part of the two-day celebrations. Plus, there were seminars.
No, you are not unclean, you are very pure. But
we have just taken the second diaspora now from India to.
And to lighten the mood, a play was also organized. But what stood out was the presence of the non-Parsis, married to members of the community. A strict no-no elsewhere. But the Delhi Parsi Anjuman has welcomed them. However, the non-Parsis are not allowed inside the temple.
Now 45% of the Delhi Parsis are intermarried. So they're not married within the community, they're married outside. And even they are very welcome in Delhi, I have to say.
Originally immigrants from Iran, the Parsis have blended well with Delhi's composite culture.
It's like when I come back from college and mom asks me, what do you want to eat? I'm actually, you know, I want dhan saag, but I want rajma chawal too.
Known for their sense of humor and their love for food. The Parsis may be a community struggling to add to their dwindling numbers, but they are not giving up just yet.
The fire will go on.
In New Delhi with camera person Gauri Prasad, Sonal Mehrotra, NDTV.